Now we bring together the two rings by twisting a wire around them. As this is our original point where we always want to refer back to, I like to put the two welds so that they are right above the original V, and then the wire that you wire them on with, I'll usually leave a longer tail so I can always distinguish that this is the starting point. This will be our reference point throughout the creation of the Gaia Sphere. So notice which way the rings are sitting on top of each other. The one that is cocked to the right is on top of the one that is to the left. Note how the third ring is woven in. Of the original two rings, the one that sits to the right, you'll notice that the third ring is on the outside of that second ring. Now then, if you go back to where the third ring crosses the second ring on the opposite side of us, it'll be on the underside. So what I'm trying to say is that when you put that third ring in, it's going to weave over under on every one of the rings that it intersects. It'll be over on one side and under on the other side. And that is the weaving pattern. Now you can simply pick it up by the third ring so that you can bring the ring together, stick it in the vise, and weld it. Then after the fact, we will wire it into place. Now we wire in the fourth ring. So you can see that it is somewhat parallel and mirrored to our very first ring. And notice that the over-under pattern is not in reference to the entire sphere as of yet. Rather, the over-under pattern is just the intersection of two rings. As we add in the sixth ring, this is when we actually get the over-under weaving pattern throughout every one of the rings. This is comparison to one of the original Gaia spheres that at one time used to be color-coded. It is still a reference that I use every time I build a Gaia sphere. So you may choose to have one that you just keep in your shop that is color-coded so that you can build it from there. It takes a little coaxing to get the sixth ring into place. I was noting the pentagonal patterns in there, and that is one way to see where the wire is going, where you have the 12 pentagrams within the Gaia Sphere. It is at this point right here that you may choose to cut the wires that are holding all the rings into place to give you a little bit more freedom of movement. It is very interesting that when I first started putting together the 177 megahertz Gaia spheres, when the sixth and last wire came together, there was oftentimes some very interesting things energetically that happened. In the beginning, it was always a wayward would come in. I don't know if they were just attracted to the light or what it was. But anyway, on the completion of the sixth wire is when you are completing the energetic tool. It depends on the gauge of wire and the size of sphere that you are making, on how clean they can come out. Otherwise, they do look a little rugged, like that tiniest guy that you can see there.